testicles are open, and this gives the rabbit the ability to retract the testicles into the abdomen during stress or from a painful stimulus. If these open inguinal rings are not closed during castration, herniation often occurs. The surgeon should perform a closed castration if possible. When the tunics are ligated during closed castration, this indirectly occludes the inguinal canal. If the tunics are not closed, as with an open castration, the rings require suture closure. The surgical pack should include 3/0 chromic gut for ligations and 4/0 vicryl on a cutting needle for skin sutures. Absorbable suture is used in the skin so that they drop out on their own. Stress and risk of injury during suture removal is thus avoided. A routine sterile surgical field is now prepared using drapes and towel clamps. Include both testicles and the prepuce in the surgical field. The penis can be seen extruded from the sheath. To assure that the depth of anesthesia is appropriate, before creating the incision, a hemostat is used to pinch the scrotum. If the rabbit reacts, the anesthetic flow rate should be increased. An incision is made at each side, just cranial to each testicle, over the spermatic cord. The cord is felt under the skin and pinched upwards with 2 fingers while keeping the testicle in the scrotum. If the testicles retract into the abdomen during the incision, deepen the anesthetic plane and gently squeeze the caudal abdomen to push the testicle back into the scrotum. The skin must be held taut over the cord to prevent incising too deep. The blade is held very lightly, remembering that the skin is quite thin. A special effort must be made to avoid incising the vaginal tunic. A curved hemostat is placed inside the skin and pushed under and around the cord to break down the spermatic fascia and to create an area to grasp the cord with the fingers. Fingers are then used to further bluntly break down the gubernacular ligament and spermatic fascia, which holds the testicle in the scrotum. Gentle pulling will then pop the testicle out of the scrotum. Be sure to squeeze the cord to milk the fat of the amyloid viscera into the abdomen before clamping. A clamp is placed across the cord, just cranial to the testicle. With a blade, the testicle is removed, and the cord is then ligated with 3/0 chromic gut. Since the clamp is not removed during ligation, the ligation should be located at least 0.5 centimeters proximal to the clamp. Using a hand-tied square knot, ligate the cord securely with 4 throws. Once the cord has been ligated, the suture is cut, and then grasp with forceps and examine thoroughly for bleeding as the clamp is removed. The ligated cord is replaced into the inguinal area. It will fill the inguinal ring and seal the canal so herniation is avoided. The same procedure is now performed on the other side, always taking care that the vaginal tunic is not incised. After the testicles are removed, the incisions look quite large due to the stretching of the thin skin. Rabbits often sit directly on their inguinal area, so the incisions must be closed. These incisions are closed with 4/0 vicryl, 3 to 4 simple interrupted sutures in each incision. The sutures should not be tied too tightly to allow for some swelling of the skin to take place. The site should be cleaned up and re-examined to determine if proper suture placement was performed. The penis will retract back into the sheath as the rabbit recovers. Rabbits will often further irritate these incisions during healing by chewing and gnawing at the area. Closely watch for bleeding, swelling, or redness caused by chewing, and promptly apply an Elizabethan collar if necessary. Holes may need to be cut in the collar for the rabbit's ears. If the rabbit is trained to a litter box, the gravel or sand must be removed and replaced with absorbent paper for at least 1 week. The cage must be kept clean, especially for the first week after surgery.